Greetings. Today's lesson, images. Images can improve the design and the appearance of your web page, especially if they are pictures of majestic things. See these? Well, they actually look like this. Let's take a look at what that means. In HTML, images are defined with the img tag. The image tag has no closing tag and is what we call an empty tag. But it should contain attributes. The src attribute specifies the URL or source of the image. Next, let's go over the alt attribute. It provides an alternative text for an image. This is helpful if the user cannot view the image because of slow connection, error in the src attribute, or the user has a screen reader. Value of the alt attribute should describe the image. So, if a browser cannot show the image, it'll display the value of the alt attribute instead. And the alt attribute is required for images in HTML. A web page will not validate correctly without it. Next, image sizes. When you start to deal with the image's width or height, use the style attribute to specify it. It should look like this. Another way to handle this is to use the width and height attributes. Make sure to note that you should always specify the width and height of the image. If they aren't specified, the page might flicker while the image loads. While the width, height, and style attributes are all valid in HTML5, we suggest using the style attribute. Now, moving back to the src attribute, and finding the specific location of an image. If not specified, the browser expects to find the image in the same folder as the web page, but it's common to store images in a subfolder. To do so, you must include the folder name in the src attribute. Another way to store images is on image servers. You can access the images from any web address in the world. You can also use animated images. No matter how you pronounce them, HTML allows animated GIFs and GIFs like this. But what if you want to use an image as a link? Just put the img tag inside the a tag like this. To make an image float to the right or left of a text, use the CSS float property like this. Want to learn more? Float over to the CSS float tutorial. Sorry, I couldn't help myself. But what if you wanted your image to be less functional and more aesthetics? Mainly a background image, to be precise. To do that, on an HTML element, use the CSS property background image, which works like this. If you only want the background image on a paragraph, specify the background image property on the P element. This is covered in depth in the CSS background tutorial. Now, we've covered a lot in this chapter, but here's one final tip. Loading images takes time. Large images can slow down your page, so use them carefully. But some are worth it.